Hi guys, my name is Bex and welcome back to my channel, and today I'll be bringing you my November wrap-up. So it is December 2nd when I'm filming this, and I cannot believe how quickly this year has flown. But what I want to share with you today is my November wrap-up. So in the month of November, I ended up reading 7 books, which is fucking fantastic. I ended up joining in the Scallywagathon, which was hosted by Ali and Amanda, and I will leave my TBR link down below so you can check it out. And I did pretty well. I read all but one of the books that I wanted to read, so let's just get into the books that I read this month. So the first book I completed for the Scallywagathon was Dear Martin by Nick Stone. Now this book was absolutely incredible. I gave it a 5 out of 5 stars and it deserved every one of these stars. This book follows Justice McAllister. He is very smart, he is an honor student, and he is set to go to the Ivy Leagues. And that is until he is put in handcuffs, and it really throws him and the way he thinks. After this traumatic event, Justice starts a little project which is trying to live like Martin Luther King Jr. And he starts writing to Martin, and it's absolutely fantastic. And this is just a moving book, and it's just, it brought out so many emotions in me. This shit actually happens in America, and I can't imagine living like this, but I think Nick Stone put in beautifully into words this story, and I could not give it more praise. It was a fantastic novel. If you liked The Hate U Give by Angie Thomas, you will love this. It talks about the same issues, police brutality, inequality, and the Black Lives Matter movement. This book definitely stands on its own, and I definitely recommend it. The next book I read for the Scallywagathon was Monstress Volume 2, The Blood by Marjorie Louis, and this is an awesome graphic novel series if you have not seen it before. The artwork is absolutely beautiful, and the storyline is gruesome and basically follows a girl who has survived war but then has a monster inside of her. So it's got monsters, it's brutal, the graphics are absolutely fantastic. And as this is the second in a series, graphic novel series just keeps getting better and better. The first one, I thought it was good, but this one I gave a 4 out of 5 stars. It was just a really, really good read. It's also really fast-paced, so if you need a book for a readathon that's fast-paced, this is for you. However, it is a bit gruesome in its artwork. It's bloody, it's murdery. If you don't like that, don't pick it up, but if you do, this is for you. The next book I read was The Lightning Struck Heart by TJ Klune, and this book is all sorts of fantastic. I was recommended this one by G from Book Roast. I'll link it down below, go check her out, she's fantastic. And this is a really, really interesting book. I actually listened to it on audiobook, which I think is the preferred way to do it. But The Lightning Struck Heart follows Sam of Wilds, who is a wizard's apprentice, and he has a massive crush on Knight, but the Knight is getting married to the Prince, which is Sam's future boss, basically. And then, yeah, Dragon comes in and takes the prince away, and this is their story. It's fantastic. It is hilarious. It is inappropriate in all the best ways. It's entertaining, and it has gay characters that just give me life. It was honestly one of the best books I've read this year, and it definitely is going to make my top 10, let's be honest. What puts this one apart, I think, is the narrator in the audiobook was beyond compare. It was the best narrated book I have heard. He had different voices for different characters, and all of them were very specific, and he just made the book really, really amazing. So I definitely recommend picking this one up. I gave it a 5 out of 5 stars, and I would say pick it up on audiobook though, because honestly the experience you cannot get by reading the book yourself. There was so much sarcasm and witty comments and just dirty humor. If you're not into inappropriate humor and sex jokes, don't read it. Don't listen to it. It's not for you. But I'd say it's for a very specific sense of humor, which is my sense of humor. But if you're into that sort of humor, it is really good, so definitely pick it up. Now the fourth book I read this month was Unearthed by Amy Kaufman and Megan Spooner, and this was my fourth read for the Scallywagathon, but I did not get this one finished in time. This is an advanced reader copy that I got from Alan and Unwin, so thank you very much to Alan and Unwin for supplying this one to me, and it was just such an amazing read. I gave Unearthed a 4 out of 5 stars. The way I describe it to people is the way it's described on the back, and it is Indiana Jones meets Lara Croft in space. And honestly, I got so many vibes of that while I was reading it. It's not even subtle. I freaking loved it. The only thing that was missing for me is a little bit more world building. I think the premise of the book built up for such amazing worlds to be built, but unfortunately it did fall a little bit short for me on this. However, It didn't fall short anywhere else. The writing was beautiful, the characters were amazing, the adventure aspect of this book was incredible, and I really, really liked what Amy and Megan did with this book. Basically, this book follows Jules and Amelia, and Earth intercepts a message from a long dead alien race, and they believe that this planet is going to fix Earth and all its issues because I believe Earth is pretty much destroyed. For Jules, who is a scholar, this is the opportunity he has been waiting for, unprecedented study of this race and their technology. However, it's illegal to go to this planet and it is covered with looters, like our other protagonist, which is Amelia, and these two meet and kind of form a shifty alliance to try to get what they both need. Really, really interesting book, and I really, really enjoyed it. Cannot wait to get my hands on the next novel in this series. The next book I read in the month of November was The Sun and Her Flowers by Rupi Kaur. This is a collection of poetry that centers around love, loss, trauma, healing, and femininity. If I said that right. It is soft, beautiful, and empowering. However, poetry is not my thing. I hoped that if I continue reading poetry, it will become my thing, but I'm really failing at this. I've read Milk and Honey, and I've also read Princess Saves Herself in this one, and now The Sun and Her Flowers, and I just cannot connect to poetry. I might pick up one more poetry book. My friend Christy from Bookworm Christy, which I'll link down below, has a poetry video up on her channel, so I'll definitely go check it out and maybe do one more poetry, but if I don't like it, then I'm just gonna have to put it down. I don't think I rate it enough because I don't feel like I enjoy it. And I just don't feel I connect to it. And the last book I read was another graphic novel, and that is Saga Volume 3 by Brian K. Vaughan. And oh my goodness, how much I love Saga. I read the first Saga and didn't really like it, and now I'm moved on to number 3, and I'm really enjoying it. I gave this one a 4 out of 5 stars as well. Basically, Saga follows like a Romeo and Juliet retelling, but with aliens. Our two main characters have a baby and have to flee for their lives because their planets are coming to try assassinate them, and it's just awesome. It's crude, it's gruesome, it's entertaining, and it's funny, and I really, really love it. So I'll definitely be continuing on with this graphic novel series as well. The last book I read for the month of November was The Witches of the Glass Castle by Gabriella Laporte. I got this one from Of Tomes for a review, which I have now up on my Goodreads and my blog. But basically, The Witches of the Glass Castle follows Mia and Dino, who are siblings that discover a family secret, which is that they are witches. A pair are sent away to study at the Glass Castle to try to uncover their gifts and learn their skills. But they are thrust into a world full of witches and hunters, and they've got to try to navigate friendship and alliances and not get killed by hunters, and it's really, really cool. The premise of the book was amazing. I love books that surround like witches or like trying to learn their craft. I think that's really, really fantastic. The writing style was good. The plot wasn't overly complex. However, this book did fall short for me. I ended up giving it a 3.25 out of 5 stars. There was an insta-love in this that I thought was a bit strange. It gave me Twilight vibes with the Edward and Bella sort of thing. I thought the characters in this book were written below their ages. They felt like they were older, but they acted younger, and that really got to me. But I did enjoy the book. I thought it was a really cool adventure. So yeah, if you're into that sort of thing, definitely check this one out. So that is all the books that I read in the month of November. I'm pretty happy with my reading month. I'm really disappointed in myself though. When November finished up, I was about 90 pages off finishing Golden Sun by Pierce Brown. So if I'd powered through, I would have read 8 books, but I didn't. So at this stage, I've finished it. But I can't tell you about it yet because it's still November. And just something a little special on the end here, I thought I'd give you a little glimpse at my TBR for December, even though the title of this video didn't say I would do that, but I'm going to because I'm impulsive. But as I said, I will be finishing Golden Sun, or I have finished Golden Sun by Pierce Brown. This is the second book in the Red Rising trilogy, and Red Rising follows Darrow, who is a red and comes from the lowest class in society. Reds have been told for their whole lives that they are setting up Mars to make it habitable. Unfortunately, they have been deceived, and it's a really, really cool dystopian. So if you're into dystopians in space, this is for you. So I'll be finishing off this one. And at this point, I've also moved on to Morning Star, which is the third and last book in the Red Rising trilogy. However, we're gonna get another book later. I am about 20% of the way through and excited to finish this one off for the month. The next book I'm going to pick up is God's Grave by Jay Kristoff, and I'm going to read this one with Clara from Clara Reads Books, and I'll leave links to her channel down below as well. I'm so excited to pick this one up. I cannot tell you how much I love Never Night. Never Night, of course, follows Mia Corvair, who is an assassin, and she goes to a school for assassins, and it's brutal, and it's gruesome, and it's fantastic. So, excited to read this one with Clara. We have started reading it already, and oh my goodness, I can't wait to talk to her about it. Every one of her videos, I'm in her comments like, tell me when you're gonna read it and I can read it too. So I forced a buddy read upon her and I regret nothing. Thanks, Clara. And the last book I'm going to get to this month is The Cruel Prince by Holly Black. This is an advanced read copy and I received it from Alan and Unwin. So thank you very much to Alan and Unwin for providing me with The Cruel Prince so I can give an honest review. Really excited about this one. It's a story about Faye. I'll read the back really quickly for you. One terrible morning, Jude and her sisters see their parents murdered in front of them. The terrifying assassins abduct all three girls to the world of the fairy, where Jude is installed in the royal court, but mocked and tormented for being mortal. Jude realizes that she will need to take part in the dangerous deception of the Fae to ever truly belong. But the stairway to power is fraught with shadows and betrayal, and looming over all is the infuriating, arrogant, and charismatic Prince Cardin. Really excited about this. All I heard was Faye, so I've got ACOTAR vibes straight away, but excited to see what Holly Black does with this new series. And here we are, that is the wrap up for November and my TBR for December. If you like this video, please give it a big thumbs up, subscribe if you'd like to see more and haven't already, and chat to me down in the comments. Let me know what you're reading in December. That's all from me today, so chat to you soon. Bye.